After repeated head impacts experienced in sports like American football, the brain can begin to shrink and deform, causing dementia-like symptoms. Why is this happening, and can we stop it? Howdy gang, I'm Trace. Thanks for watching DNews today. Chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or CTE, is a serious condition first discovered in the 1920s with boxers, because boxers get hit in the head a lot, both during practice and during a match. According to one medical examiner in the 1928 issue of the Journal of the American Medical Association, nearly one half of the fighters who have stayed in the game long enough will experience something they called being, quote, punch drunk, slug nutty, or peculiarly cutting paper dolls. In the 20s, they termed this dementia pugilistica, word of the day, pugilist, which means boxer, but today we call this derangement CTE. Even nearly 100 years ago, these specialists were recognizing repeated cranial impact has huge implications. The brain is bound by the same laws of physics as everything else, and thus will move until something stops it, namely the skull. This is called a concussion. And even a minor one has a serious effect on your brain box. If a smack is hard enough, the brain tissues can become deformed or permanently damaged. Even lesser sub-concussions, when taken together, can affect the brain long term. Basically, any activity where the head comes to a sudden stop repeatedly has the potential to trigger concussions and additively will cause this degenerative brain disease. CTE has been found in people who play American football, ice hockey, soccer, rugby, boxing, and wrestling, plus members of the military. Even people who only played in high school could develop CTE later. This is shocking stuff. And I just want to stop and say, according to the laws of physics, more pads do not stop the brain from moving inside of the skull any more than larger bumpers stop a person moving in a car crash. In another study from the 1920s, boxers' brains were looked at after death in an autopsy, which is when they realized something was wrong. Their brains had atrophied or shrunk. Even though we recognized this in professional athletes almost a century ago, it's only been in the news now because there likely wasn't an awareness of the problem before. CTE is difficult to diagnose because it manifests as behavioral changes that mimic other brain disorders like Alzheimer's or Parkinson's. Once the neurons and axons in the brain are permanently altered from the repeated impacts, so too is behavior, emotional control, memory, reasoning skills, physical and mental controls. CTE affects everything. The brain reacts to these impacts by literally shrinking. That's what they found in these boxers. It was called cerebral atrophy. In modern studies, doctors found as much as a 30% loss of the frontal, parietal, and temporal lobes. The damage centers on collections of neurons infused with a protein called tau. Tau normally helps stabilize neurons in the brain, but in CTE, it manifests as neurofibrillary tangles, turning the brain a yellow color. Neurofibrillary tangles are literally that. They look like the tau protein threads have become bundled up, and though how this happens isn't entirely understood by science, all the patients who have CTE have these tau tangles. In the end, as the brain shrinks and the amount of tangles grows, the person gets more aggressive and less emotionally and physically stable, and frighteningly, more suicidal. Or so it's thought. We can't look at the brain until after they're dead. Obviously, this is all bad, but can we do anything about it? CTE, Alzheimer's, and Parkinson's are all called tauopathic diseases. And unfortunately, research on living people with these disorders is still ongoing, and as of now, there is no cure. Which means, once CTE sets in, usually in middle age, decades after the repeated impact occurred, nothing can be done. Chronic traumatic encephalopathy is manifesting in athlete after athlete because they've spent their whole careers smashing into one another, either on purpose or on accident. And even this week, there was another death attributed to the mental anguish that comes along with this brain disorder. In the end, our brains are the source of everything we are. Sometimes a concussion can knock a person unconscious, or worse, they can slip into a coma. But what exactly is a coma? Luckily for you, I've looked into that right here.
Every coma is different, depending on the part of the brain being starved. Some comatose patients will twitch, while others will not breathe on their own. The Glasgow Coma Scale assigns a ranking from 3 to 15, 3 being a deep coma, and 15 being awake and responsive.
Does the discovery of CTE and its mental and behavioral consequences make you rethink about joining sports or for encouraging athletes to hit each other for our entertainment? Tell us down in the comments and keep coming back here every day for more DNews. Make sure you subscribe.